non-cyclic photophosphorylation. In non-cyclic photophosphorylation, the assimilation energy is released by transportation of electrons among the cytochrome oxidants, and also proton translocation also being taken here. Here, two photosystems are involved, photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. At first stage of non-cyclic photophosphorylation, the electrons are absorbed by reaction center of P680. Above 680 wavelengths of light is absorbed by the PS2. Then we said as it is excited P680 center. While it is excitation, it loses the two electrons and it get oxidized. It transferred the electrons to the electron acceptor. The first primary electron acceptor is pheophytin, which is colorless pigment. By taking of two electrons, it reduced. Then it gives electrons to the cytochrome B. Here is a series of oxidation as well as reduction reactions are happened. But here, after reduction, the pheophytin releases the two electrons to the plastoquinone. Then there it oxidized. It means they go for reduction again. For their reduction, here need of two electrons again. How two electrons are compensate? To compensation of two electrons, here the water molecule is splitted. One water molecule splitted into 2H plus and 2 electrons plus half O2. In non-cyclic photophosphorylation, one water molecule is cleaved that resulted to the release of half oxygen molecule. And also 2 electrons, 2 protons are released. The released electrons are being taken by reaction center P680, oxidized P680. Then it get reduced. You see here, up to here the electrons are reached. Between pheophytin and cytochrome B, there is a plastoquinone cycle. So plastoquinone cycle means here also again reduction and oxido reactions are carried out. So among these cytochrome oxidants, the electrons are transmitted. Finally, they reached onto the plastocyanin. Then from plastocyanin to they are reached into P700. By taking of two electrons, P700 also get excited and it go for the downstream electron transportation. There one enzyme is worked out. What is that? NADP oxidoreductase. In the presence of that enzyme, the NADPH is released. Two NADPH2s are released. And here, the protons are released. The released protons are translocated into the lumen of thylakoids. Totally, if you observe the electron transportation as shape-wise, it look as alphabet Z. That's why the scheme is called as Z scheme. In the Z scheme, there is a production of ATP as well as NADPH2. So here NADPH is released. How the ATP is released? So translocated protons are produced proton gradient. Against the proton gradient, they move from the lumen to stroma. While they are moving, they come from the one enzyme that is ATPH. When they are moving from the ATPH, there is a, for three protons, there is a production of one ATP. So that we said in the form of photophosphorylation. Photophosphorylation is nothing but of production of ATP in the presence of light. During the photosystems, the ATP is synthesized either cyclic or non-cyclic. The released protons are entered into the ATP synthesis.